Now let's go ahead and make some tile elements and add them to the board. So I'm going to go back and in my HTML, let me start by getting rid of these two tiles. And then in my JavaScript, I noticed one thing when I was looking at this video before is I don't really want to do this twice. So let's go ahead and do it once instead. So we'll create a margin local variable and then we'll just set the margin. Because jQuery is not super cheap. Not too bad, but definitely cheaper to only do it once. So let's go ahead and create some tiles, and I'm going to do that before the resize event so that all the tiles get resized. And I'm going to call a function called init tiles. And what I want to do is have a global variable right now called tiles, and it's going to be an array of arrays. So the first array is going to have tile 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the second is going to have 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 9, 10, 11, 12, and then 13, 14, 15, and nothing. So that's going to be the gap. And then I'm also going to keep track of the gap, but I'll come back to that. So these are the values that I want to have. And if I want to access, say, this tile here, the first element is going to be the Y. So tile sub 0 is that row. Tile sub 1 is that row. Tile sub 2 is that row. And so on. So the first element is the row, and then the second element is the column. So if I wrote, for example, tiles sub 3 sub 4, that would be 0, 1, 2, 3, and then 0, 1, 2, 3. So I'm actually off the edge. Let's say 2 instead. So that's this one right here. And then if I made it like 1, 3, here's row 1, and here's value 3 of row 1. So the first thing is Y, and the second thing is X. So I'll just leave these for documentation, but what I want to do in init tiles is I want to write a loop inside of a loop. So for var x equals 0, x less than 4, x plus plus. So x is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then for each one, for y equals 0, y less than 4, y plus plus. I want to make a new tile, set some properties, and then add it to the board, and also store it in the right place in this tiles array. So let's start by making a tile. And I want to do something special for this element right here, but I'll come back to that. No, I'll do it right now. So first I want to calculate the value that goes in the tile. So the value is going to be y times 4. So 0, 4, 8, 12 plus x, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, plus 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And then if value is less than 16, so I want tiles 1 through 15, then I'm going to do something. So the first thing I want to do here is I want to create a tile. And in jQuery, once again, if you pass in as a selector a blob of HTML, It's going to go ahead and give you a jQuery object with an HTML element underneath it based on that blob of HTML. So I can put a div tag here, class equal tile, and I can put a span in here or not. I guess I won't put a span, but I will go ahead and add in value. So there's the number, and then I'll close off my div tag. So that gives me an HTML element. And then I'm going to add that to the board. So let's get the board. And we'll append tile. And if I wanted to be super efficient, I could get the board once here at the top. And then just say board.append tile. So it saves a little tiny bit of work, probably not significant, but. So now I've created a tile, I've added it to the board, and for convenience, I want to know the position of this tile. So I not only want to be able to say, give me the tile in this position, but I also want to be able to say, given a tile, what position is it in? So I want to store that on this tile objects somehow, and this is an HTML element. So the standard way of doing that is you create a data attribute on your HTML element, and you can pretty much put anything you want there. In regular straight JavaScript, you create an attribute like data-x and store the value here. In jQuery, you can just say, since tile is a jQuery object, you can just say tile.data x, and then we're going to put the x value there. And then I can also chain these together, y, and put the y value there. So that's all I need to do to store the x and y location on the tile object. Now let's go ahead and store the tile in our array. So tile sub y x is tile. And then I also want to set the color. So I want the even ones to be pink and the odd ones to be green. So if x mod 2, so this is going to be 0 for even numbers and 1 for odd numbers, and 0 is falsy. So if this is true, that means it's an odd tile. So tile dot I think this is a CSS property, so tile dot background color. Let's make that pink. Otherwise, if it's even, tile CSS background color light green. So that should be everything for tiles. Let's go ahead and load it and see what we get. Okay, now you'll notice that these don't quite fit on a row. And part of the reason is because of the scroll bar and also because of some margin and padding. So let's go ahead and get rid of the scroll bar on the body tag. So body, let's go overflow hidden. And while we're here, let's also get rid of the margin, because I want to take up the full screen. And let's see how we're doing. Okay, so these boxes have some padding on them. They have 2 pixels of margin plus 1 pixel of border. So let's go ahead and declare those as constants. Margin is 2. And border is 1. And then when I'm setting the size of this thing, I want to subtract off the margin and the border. So make that minus margin minus border. And here's how I chain these together on multiple lines to make it a little easier to read. And we'll do that here too. And now let's see what we get. Okay, so still not quite working. Let's go ahead and look at what we have. So the width is 218.25, and the board is 885 to 18.25. So 885 over 4. But then let's look at this board here. I think I might have a rounding issue. Let's go ahead and math.floor to round this down. So fractional pixels always cause problems. Okay, I probably have another pixel somewhere. So 885, 220 times 4 is 880. But then I probably have another extra pixel here somewhere. So let's go ahead and see what we have. Okay, so let's get a tile. So it's 218. And So 218 plus 3 plus 3. Oh, yeah, there's margin and border on both sides, not just one side. So I have to multiply this by 2. And let's go ahead and calculate. Extra space is 2 times margin plus border. And then we'll subtract off extra in both places. All right, so I was only counting half. Good, and now it fits. So I got this backwards. It's going 1, 2, 3, 4 instead of that way. So let me take a look at what's going on. Well, that looks right to me. Let's take a look at what we have in tiles. So tiles sub 0 should be the top row. So that should be this element here, and here's the data on there. And then this one should be 5, this guy right here, so that's x1, y0. And let's look at the text. So that's a 2. Oh, I'm appending them in the wrong order. This will get fixed actually when I position these absolutely. So I'm actually okay right now. It just has to do with the order that I'm adding them. But let me go ahead and fix that anyhow, just for consistency. So I'm going to put the while loop on the outside, and then the order they get appended will actually match the order they're in the array. So that's what I want.